Yeah, thank you very much. And now I will pass the floor to Muralidhar. Request you to take the floor, Murali.
Oh, yeah. I will share the slides.
Okay, sir.
All of you are able to see the slide?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
Good evening, sir. Myself, Muralidhar Bhatt. So I've been with multiple auto component industries in the past 35 years. In that 35 years, I was also part of this textile machinery manufacturers group, which is LMW. I worked for LMW for 4 years at their Gummidipundi plant. So I was heading their manufacturing unit. So that's how I'm happy to be back again with this textile machinery manufacturers group. And I have been with multiple companies other than LMW. I was there with TVS and also with Rane. And in 2001, I joined Gabriel. So since then, I was working with Gabriel, and April 21, I retired from Gabriel and I started my own consultancy services, which is called as ISTR. To brief something about introduction, ISTR is a company which will key modules are innovation, product and process costing, and human efficiency improvements. Because these are the major three modules which are required specifically in the industry now. Looking at that, we are offering. And innovation, of course, is a systematic way of thinking how innovation can be done in your own product and process and services. And also product costing. We also give the services on product and product costing. That is end-to-end costing. So also it talks about how the costing can be fine-tuned and red parts can be converted into green. And also we talk about human efficiency. Here we are talking about, like you might have heard about overall equipment efficiency when TPM, but how do I improve human efficiency? Because people are working in the shop floor, how will I improve their efficiency? There's a technically, scientifically measured data. Based on that data, we measure their time and effort, how much they are putting in their one shift operation, and how this can be improved. This is what we provide, these three services. Coming to waste elimination, when this subject was given to me, so I think waste elimination as a subject, it is known everywhere. Now, what we did in Gabriel, that's what I will be talking about. We need to do it differently. Waste elimination, we know that, we already know. What is waste elimination? These are the types of wastes. We say it is there in our mind that these are the types of waste which is written long time, and it is there in the process. What is waste? Overproduction, correction, material movement, processing, inventory, waiting, motion, and lack of employee. These are the 8 types of waste which is impressed or impregnated in our mind. It is there in our mind. So whenever we ask, even in dream, we may say that what are the types of waste we say. But the question is that we need to do something different to achieve big difference or big impact in a smaller time. So that's why we said that if I have to transform my company into a big leap, I cannot be doing this only these 8 waste. Looking at these 8 waste, we need to first look at large impact, and also we need to look at how to change people. So then we said that the key word what we talked about is transform people to transform the organization. So if I have to transform people, what should I do? First, I have to transform people. First, we need to focus on people. Then automatically the organization will get transformed. Now to look at how to transform the people, let us understand simple. This is the logic which we created where you have reactive action and proactive action. And also we have incremental benefit and quantum benefit. These are the four tenets which contributes into any transformation or mindset thinking process. Now when we say look at this quadrant one, it talks about it is reactive action, but benefit is incremental. Now when it is when we talk about this, it is problem solving. All problem solving, we react when the problem arises and take action on that problem when the benefit is incremental. Once that problem is solved, we be proactive in the quadrant two, the same incremental benefit, and then we say that we have taken continuous improvement activity on that problem. So that means the quadrant one and two talks about both reactive and proactive actions, but benefit is incremental. So this lower half of this quadrant, what we call it as incremental mindset. Our mindset is incremental. We will wait for the problem to come, react, and then once the problem is solved, we get the benefit as incremental. And then to prevent that problem coming back again, we be proactive, do continuous improvement activities, and get that same incremental benefit. Now, we wanted in Gabriel to move people to a quantum benefit. So that means that person is having reactive action and also he has to get quantum benefit. If he has to get quantum benefit, he has to go into quadrant three. What is this quadrant three? Quadrant three is reactive. I have to get quantum benefit. So what we call it as catch-up jumps. Catch-up jumps means look at your own competitor. What is that he is doing? Look at his activities. Look at his, the way he is working on his business. Be reactive, but you have to get quantum benefit. So that is the area where quadrant people are working on it. Whereas if you see, we need to work on quadrant four. Quadrant four is we have to be proactive. We cannot be waiting for my competitor to do quantum benefit and then I work on the quantum benefit. I cannot be always in the catch-up jump. I have to be proactive and also be on quantum benefit. So now this quadrant, what we call it as generative leaps. So that means why we call it as generative leap. Leap is an arch where you leap, and if you don't leap the next generative leap, you will come down. So that means consistently you have to have that generative leap. And this upper half of this quadrants, we call it as big picture mindset. You need to look at big picture. So what is this big picture? So what we said that means we have to break the mindset. So let us understand what is this mindset is. I'll be showing you a picture. Now at an instant, look at this picture and decide is this picture is right or wrong. How many of you feel that this picture is right? Or how many of you feel this is wrong?
So just type in yes, that's it, right or wrong. So we'll know. Just 1 minute, all of you just type right or wrong.
Yes, it is very, very important because this is a changeover time. You have to think differently.
Correct. So we will, yes, please. I've got one wrong. Continue, please. Continue. I'm going to give 2 minutes for this because this whole session is about, we'll give 2 minutes for this because I got two wrongs. Continue, please. I want more answers, please. Right or wrong? Three wrongs. Please continue. Four wrongs. Please continue. One right. Continue. Please. Right. Okay. Continue. Two rights. Continue, please. So far, we've got 4 versus 2, but totally there are about, I'd say, another 14 answers that can come in because I'm leaving out the secretariat and some of the speakers and such people. So I've got 6 answers, but I need 8 more. So can I get 8 more answers, please, amongst the membership?
Truly, it has to be interactive session.
Yes, otherwise, you know, Murli has taken so much time, and equally you have taken so much time to join us. So make your time productive and worthwhile, you know, please.
Yes.
We've got only 6. There's one of the things that I've always told you is there is nothing like failure in life. Right now we are failing because we are not answering. That's the reason why we are failing.
Yes, yes. I think, please understand all the participants, your answer both right and wrong, both are correct.
Both are correct. Absolutely right.
If you say right, it is correct answer. If you say wrong, that is also correct answer.
So I would leave one more minute and then we will cross over. It's 16:56 in my watch. So I say 16:58, 1.5 minutes still, because this is important. And Murli has given us a license that we can be all right. So please, yes. He said all of us can be right. So please submit your answer now, please. Yes. We have got 4.
Both are correct. So do not look at others' answer.
Yes.
What is it you felt at that fraction of second? That is important.
Okay, so Murli, let us say you've got 4 wrongs and 2 rights. Now continue, please. Please continue, Murli.
Yes. Now, let us look at what is wrong. I felt that this is wrong. Why do I feel this as a wrong? Because this map is not the way I have been seeing. When I was in school, my teacher told me that the map is supposed to be other way around. That has been fixed in my mind. By chance, if I had hold this map this way, my teacher would have beaten me and told, stupid fellow, this is not the way, it is opposite way. That's right. So what has happened? People have made you to think that this is the only way. There is no other way. Now, looking at the map, if you say it is wrong, it is not wrong. It is right. But when you say wrong, it is wrong. You are right. Why? Because somebody has told you this is wrong. That's why it is wrong. Now, if I say it is right, it is right. Why? Because I am able to read Australia. I am able to read Brazil. That means it is not ulta, it is right. Now, what we called this whole concept of mind, we called it as conditioning of mind. Mind as condition. So how to eliminate this conditioning of this mind? I need to change the way I am looking at things, the way I am looking at what has been taught to me. So that means I have to change. So if I have to change, of course, yes, I am ready to change. But what I have to change? The first thing I have to change is my behavior. Now, when we said about behavior, there is a model which is called as behavior model, which if you see in the lower half of this X, there is an initiative, alignment, and openness. These are the three factors which influences behavior. When this initiative, alignment, and openness are in the lower side of your mindset, you are always in the detractive mode. What is detractive? Detractive is something, no, this is not the way, it cannot be done this way. You be negative in your mind. When this initiative, alignment, openness starts moving from low to high, you move yourself from passive, participative, contributory, and finally generative. So this is a common behavior of an individual. If you see, if you watch yourself tomorrow in your own office, right from morning to evening, you will be moving from detractive to generative behavior frequently. Suddenly somebody says something, your boss says something, you come down to detractive. And your assistant has done fantastic job, suddenly you became generative. So you have to maintain generative behavior most of the time. So this is what is a major important factor, what we influenced people to look at these three factors of initiative, alignment, and openness. By that, he was able to move from detractive to generative. The next change what we did is the attitude change. How will I change a person's attitude? If you see, when you saw this map, at a small instant, you took a decision saying that this is wrong. If you see the first three or four response, immediately it was wrong. What was that? It was that behavior was started with, or attitude started with judgment. You judged that it is wrong. If you had put this process of think, discuss, share, what is new in this information? What is the information I'm talking about? What is new in this? If you had looked at, then your judgment would have been different. So that means, as in practice, you need to think first, then discuss, then share, and find out what is the information it is having and what is new in this, then finally take the judgment. So this is how we skilled and trained people to move into changed behavior and changed attitude. And the third part what we took out is thinking. So we have to change the way he is thinking, because he has been trained to think like this. He has been caged, or his boundaries are fixed. He is thinking within the boundary. He has to open his boundary. How to open this boundary? He knows what, but unfortunately he did not know how. Now he knew that we have to think out of the box. His boss used to always say, why don't you think out of the box? He always had a question, how to think out of the box? That I don't know. So that means we developed a model called how to think systematically in a five-layered thinking method. We developed this model of systematic five-layered thinking methodology. So when we talk about this five-layered, it makes you to think in a stepwise, something like an SOP. There is step one, step two, step three, and so on. So you can start thinking. We developed this somewhere in 2010, we developed, and then applied this, and based on this, Gabriel as a company wanted to do something different. So what we did is, he said, we will not talk about that eight waste. We talk about as a corporate drive. And that drive was called as Core 90. Core 90 means cost reduction in 90 days. So that means I need to focus on all the possible waste, categorize under these five tenets, and take up or identify actions and complete the actions in 90 days. From start to end is only 90 days is available. Balance the 9 months, you are going to take benefit of this drive. So we identified the major five tenets like FOH, VOH, manpower cost, RMC, and working capital. And under each of these tenets, we also identified major points like repair and maintenance, warranty, interest cost. Then VOH, we talked about electricity and fuel, because maximum we consume this. Freight, tooling and consumable, because a lot of toolings and consumables we use. In manpower cost, we identified people working in the shop floor are called as blue collar, and people working in the offices are called as white collars. RMC projects, we identify RMC projects, internal rejection, inventory. And also in working capital, we talked about FG inventory and receivables. Now, if you see, the eight waste which is identified in the first slide has been clearly identified as a challenge for Gabriel. Now, when we say that each of these repair, maintenance, warranty, so each of these heads were given to functional heads to take up these activities as a leader and drive across the company, not only in the plant where he is working, he has to deploy this across all the plants of Gabriel. So this is how it is driven. And there is a standard meet which happens every week, which is attended by MD and CXO team members. All top functional heads are meeting, and they give that guidance and quick actions and quick resources required to ensure that this is done in 90 days. And each of these pillar heads, like I'll just explain one of the pillar, like manpower cost. When we talked about manpower cost, that particular pillar head has to identify multiple actions or major areas of actions required to be done to control this manpower cost. For example, blue collar manpower cost has to be reduced. So that means, how will I do this? So that is how we called it as human efficiency improvement model, where we called it as E improvements. That means I have to first, there are four quadrants: efficiency improvement, flow improvement, cycle time reduction, and headcount reduction. Now, first we need to understand, how do I measure this efficiency of a human? Operating machine efficiency, we are able to do it through OE. TPM tells you how OE is calculated. Availability, productivity, and quality rating, all these three multiplied will give you OE. Now, how will I measure human efficiency? We developed this model where human efficiency is human work. How much time he is engaged with the product into quantity produced divided by number of people used in that line. So this measures human efficiency. Now, when we say human efficiency measurement, we also wrote down multiple areas where we need to work, like downtime reduction, changeover time reduction, speed loss elimination, clubbing of operation, formation ratio. Formation ratio is a model which is of Heijunka production system from TPS. So we also took this as an input, where how can I improve formation ratio? Formation ratio is nothing but the total work content or the human work divided by cycle time into the number of people working on that line. So it gives you a formation ratio. How will I do layout improvement? I have to do route reduction, I have to do waste time elimination, I have to do manual time reduction, I have to do, and machine time reduction, I have to do. These are the areas where we worked, and we have been working from past almost now 2011 onwards. We have been working both on areas of waste elimination and some using the innovation or thinking technique, what I talked about, the three changes: behavior change, attitude change, and thinking change. By applying this, we are able to get these results. You can see from March 12, we started measuring. So initially we involved 12 people in this, and 12 tenants and the major 12 tenants we identified, and we started working on it, and they took up the challenge. They're able to create an impact of 19 million in that year. And also we had only 5 patents at that time. You may be aware that Gabriel is a pure Indian company. There is no collaboration or anybody. So a pure Indian company has its own R&D center in Pune and Hosur. These are the two places where we had only 5 patents. Looking at the benefit what we got, we involved more people and we went on. And as of March 20, we have 750 people trained in that model of change, that is behavior model, attitude model, and thinking model. So we have around roughly around 250 challenges are running across Gabriel. People are running the challenges, and the impact what has created is 394 million cumulative impact what has been created. And if you see, the best part is the patent. Starting of this journey, we had 5 patents. Today we have 110 patents. That is what I call it as big picture impact, big picture mindset change. So that means just by changing the way you think, you are able to do big impact. So this is what we could do it. And also I can show something on manpower. By using this human efficiency model, we are able to improve that, what we call it as MOP. It is measure of performance. It is initially, it started with 212 minutes of work. Physical work actually is doing, validation work he is doing, to the time of 450 minutes. Against 450, he is able to only put 212, and now that has increased to 280. And this year we are having a target of 350, and that's how we want to change. By doing this human efficiency improvements, the number of people who have been reduced, you can see 2018-19 data I have, because that big data, I'm not able to put it in this. So every year we are able to save roughly around in the range of 50 to 100 people in the system. And every year the plan is having that 70 for this year and 40 for next year and so on. So this is how we are able to achieve the big impact. And this has happened only because of two things. One is we always wanted to be in the quadrant 4. And also we adopted the change of behavior, attitude, and thinking. So because we could do this, we are able to get this big impacts. So I think that's all from my side, what we could do it. So I will not, go into that waste elimination. What are the tenants? Because each industry has their own type of waste. So broader view, if you see that tenants, what we token out, it is common across all types of industry. Every textile industry or process industry, they have UOH, they have FOH, they have MPC, they have RMC, they have areas of France. So all these are available. Okay, this is standard. So that's why I wanted to focus on common subjects rather than I talking about what has been done in Gabriel. So this is how we are able to do it. And this is how we could get the result. So before I close, one of the statements Mr. Will Rogers, where he talked about is, even if you are on the right track, you will get run over if you just sit there. That's all from my side. Thank you. Hello.
Yeah, you're listening. Yeah, Murali, thank you very, very much for sharing with us a totally new perspective because while I gave a handout, I talked about the seven wastes, but I realized that those wastes have been considered by you as a tier two subject. You first talked about change in attitude, change in thinking. I think those were the two that I could broadly recall. Maybe there is definitely one more attribute. And because of that, you could then generate those seven ways. Little that I would like to tell my friends over here is, one of the things that I've seen in many companies is, nobody is allowed to come to a meeting with a pen and a paper. All the pen and paper is kept outside the conference room. All the mobiles are outside, and for perhaps 2 hours, there will be just a speaker and there will be some talk and all of that. At the end of 2 hours, they will give you 5 minutes to write down what did you learn in those 5 minutes, then return the papers again, and again for 2 hours, they will do that. And some of the companies are adopting only 4 hour sessions, not more than that for any training. So that's one way of doing what I'm about to tell you in the second sentence. I went to meet one friend of mine and he says, Kirti, what will you have? You know, I said, I'll have a cup of tea. You know, so he kept pouring tea and then he kept on pouring and pouring and the cup was overflowing. You know, I said, Are Murli, what are you doing? You know, you're wasting so much tea, you know, and all that. He says, Kirti, that's precisely why I called you. When your cup is overflowing, it shows that your mind is also overflowing. I would be happy if you had let me be quiet and I would have stopped only after you keep, because I know that I'm wasting tea, but at the same time, I want you to focus on having an empty mind. All of us at every meeting should have an empty mind. And this is something which Murli also talked about, which is something related to what new are you thinking of? Because yes, let's go to that photograph. A few of us thought it was right, a few of us was right, wrong. But real thing is, with an empty mind, he says, your answer is perfectly right. It's the way you look at it as such. So those were two ideas of how we can eliminate waste. I'll now leave the floor open because we have 13 minutes left. And it's important that I see a new past president with us. Devin Dembla is here, so I'd like him to ask a few questions. Suresh Vaidya, a big stalwart in the industry. Please, y'all can start raising a few questions to Murli. The floor is open for everybody to raise questions to Murli. And let us make it interactive, please. Devin, some questions from your side, please. Suresh, some questions from your side. Dr. Suman. Mr. Mathre, any questions? Since you have met so many textile mills.
No question just now. It has been very interesting session. And I wish he had more time to elaborate on other matters also. So thank you very much.
Yes, yes. See, this is a long process of skilling people. So that is what is a service I give it. I think you can contact Mr. Kirti. So he will give you the details of mine. So then we can work on how people can be transformed.
Along with this, the short answer is the first Wednesday of every month is a tutorial month. That the speech that took place on the 21st of July, we do a ready, a catch up. So on the first Wednesday of every month, we ask all the participants to raise any questions they want. So So that window is available, and I'll speak to Murali. I'll ask him to try and be there with us so yes. that on this subject, I could see that the first part of it was very, very interesting, because a mindset change is more important than the mechanical waste elimination. So that window is available as such. Please go ahead. Anybody, any more questions? Siddhi and Narendra and Girish, I have not heard from you. Suman, not heard from you. So I'd be too happy to hear something from you people. And this time we have some of the old players are not there. So that is a little bit disappointing. But well, everybody should try and attend. So, any others?
Sir, I have one question regarding the score 90.
Yes, please.
How it works?
Okay. If you see, first is the core 90 talks about that cost reduction 90. So normally our financial year is from April to March. So normally we have our KRA setting process in the month of April. Okay. So when what we call it as LSIP, large scale interactive process. Across the company, there are roughly around 500 people who are staff. So out of that, the selective functional heads and department heads and key department people are called centrally to one place. This time, of course, it has happened on through the online. So they are called to the center. And if you see that five tenants, on that five tenants, the targets are fixed. What should be my target for manpower cost? What should be my target for RMC? The target is fixed. And also the time plan is already there, 90 days. And the KRAs are fixed right on that LSIP day. And the weightage given is 50% weightage is on core 90. 50%. Because that's what we want everybody to do it. 50% weightage is on core 90. Balance everything is his functional activities, whatever he wants to do. But major is core 90. Because that is what we have to do it. So that is fixed. And they go back. They work out their requirements, whatever the resource requirement. They need some investment, need some help from the corporate office. So that is being raised, and the presentation is done every Tuesday between 3 o'clock to 4 o'clock to MD and COOs, those in different functions, and the central function team sitting, and they give approvals for any requirement in that meeting. For example, there is a fund requirement of say 2 lakhs. Immediate approval is given in that meeting. He informs CFO, please sanction this fund. They have to do these activities. That is how it is done. Because 90 days, within 90 days, it has to be done. There is no time. If you don't do it within 90 days, the KRA is below. KRA below means there is a negative scoring. Met is equal to 1. Below is negative scoring. If you exceed, if you are able to complete all the tasks within 90 days, it is 1.5 times. That's a model. If you are able to do within 60 days, all the actions you have identified to meet the targets, you have done it within 60 days, your KRA met is, instead of 50 score, you get 100. So that means you can get 150 out of 100. That is uniqueness.
Okay.
So this is how it is driven, because that is the only drive which is available in Gabriel. Everything falls under this.
Okay, thank you.
Hope I answered your question.
Yes, yes.
Thank
you. You know, the learning from what Murali has shared is, you know, interaction of data. People are told well in advance what is expected. They're given an opportunity and they're giving a timeline in doing something. There are the plus and minus. But if you see the whole process, it's more of result oriented, result driven, you know. As I think what Will Rogers said, if you are on that track and if you're not moving, then you are left behind. So that is what Murali has really told us, that I have given all you people 90 days. And if you do it in 60 days, I will give you a chocolate and some roses. If not, you will be left behind. So obviously you would not want to be left behind. And I think that is a learning for all of us, you know, that sharing of ideas, clarity and result is the only way we can go forward, you know. We still have about 5 minutes or 4 minutes. So anybody else for any questions? Once again, Devane, Vittal, Matre, and I see Mr. Pathak has also joined us. So he's new, but obviously he's not necessarily new. Mr. Pathak, would you like to share something with us? Some questions you'd like to raise on the floor today? And Girish, anything? Yes, Praveen Bhai, something? Praveen Bhai is our coordinator for the Ahmedabad region. So he is in contact with all the members to, you know, participate in all Itama activities in which attending lean management is one of many that he encourages the members in Ahmedabad and Gujarat to participate in ITAMA activities. You know. And Nandini is from Coimbatore. She encourages everybody from the south of India to participate in the ITAMA activities. You know. All right, friends, it's a little bit embarrassing that you close a session prior to anything. But first, on behalf of all of us, I'd like to thank Murali very, very much for giving us a totally new perspective on waste elimination. He asked us to start first, you know, with a change in mindset. And after the change in mindset, then we go more towards approaching the seven ways that he mentioned, like, you know, of course, I just reread these, which I've sent out to you earlier: overproduction, waiting, transportation, processing, inventory, movement, and defects. These are the seven standard. But Murali had raised the bar by talking of an additional seven that were mentioned by him in the chart that he showed us, in which two were just about excess manpower and then reduction in raw material costs, reduction in consumable tools. Those are three of seven that I can instantly remember, but his presentation is available, so we can always go back to the classroom and, you know, read his presentation once again and learn from it. So in concluding, I'd like to thank Murali very, very much for, you know, being with us today and sharing with us also. Thank you very much, Murali. Also like to thank Vasant. And just a reminder, the first Wednesday of August, I don't know the instant date, but that's just the first Wednesday. And we will have a meeting from 4:45 to 5:30 p.m. It's a open house meeting and it is meant to give clarity on all the doubts that you have had in the immediate two sessions that we concluded today about visual management and waste elimination, and even the previous seminars that we did 1S, 2S, customer satisfaction, Kaizen, and red inventory disposition and inventory management. Those were held in the previous six sessions. Today we talked about waste elimination and visual management. So it's open house and you are free to ask any questions. I will do my best to try and answer those questions for you. And I will try and bring Murli, because Murli is an expert. He's covered all these things. So I'm sure he could throw light on the questions at that point of time. So thank you very much to Murli and to Vasant. Thank you to all the participants for being with us this evening. Thank you. Bye-bye. Be safe. Good night.
Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye. Thanks. Very nice, Mr. Murli.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Very nice.
You.